Your customers have a lot to say about how you do business. But do you have the right tools in place to truly listen to them?
You know, some of your listening is going to be a one-time topical deep dive to be able to answer a specific business question. Others are going to require some ongoing listening to be able to track and trend the impact that your actions and improvements are having on the customer experience.
It's time to talk about your customer listening architecture. And we're not just talking about the occasional survey here or there. On this episode of the CX Leader Podcast.
The CX Leader Podcast with Steve Walker is produced by Walker, a business consulting firm that helps our clients unlock the potential of their customer experiences by placing the customer at the heart of all their business decisions. You can find out more at walkerinfo.com.
Hello, I'm Steve Walker, Chairman and CEO of Walker Information, and thank you for listening to this episode of the CX Leader Podcast, where we explore topics and themes to help leaders like you leverage all the benefits of their customer experience and help your customers and prospects want to do more business with you. It goes without saying that listening to your customers is vital to the customer experience strategy, but how you listen is critical. The occasional customer survey may not be enough, and yet the pendulum can swing both ways. You can be using every tool in the CX professional's toolbox and still not capture the critical insights your company needs to best serve your customers. It's an important topic, and we're going to devote three episodes to exploring how you can build your customer listening architecture. And to start us off, I'm delighted to be joined by my colleague and friend, Allison Grayson, a vice president here of consulting at Walker. And she's going to kick off this series. Allison, welcome back to the CX Leader Podcast.
Thank you very much. Glad to be back.
Well, nice to have you. I know this is an area of CX that you are particularly passionate about. So why don't you just give us sort of an overview to how an experienced CX pro consultant like you thinks about customer listening architecture?
Sure, happy to. You know, I think as CX leaders, as you mentioned, you know, we know that customer experience is so much more than just deploying a customer satisfaction survey. But actually what we see organizations' journey to developing CX within their practice really tends to start out that way. Typically, it's, you know, somebody who has asked to launch a survey. Maybe it's your support organization that says, I need to know how I'm doing. You know, let's get some transactional listening or event-based listening in place. Other times, it's an executive saying, I need my NPS number. So oftentimes, it does start with a survey. But and actually, depending on how you start, it really can color how the organization thinks about customer listening and how they evolve in their customer listening strategy over time. And I think what we see is we recognize that while that's often the case, it's probably not the best way to really approach your CX listening strategy. And some of us might be lucky enough that we're just starting out a journey. And so things like the CX architecture is a great way to design in a purposeful manner. But most of us are dealing with some legacy things that are in place already, a variety of surveys throughout the organization. So when we think of listening architecture, we think about how can we take a step back, think about what your organizational strategy is, what do you have in place, and how can we design it in a purposeful way to help support not only your organizational strategy, but also think about it from the customer perspective and really make sure that you're listening to the things that are most important to them as well.
That's a really interesting comment you made, that sometimes it starts with a survey, and thank goodness for that, or we wouldn't be in business. But I think what we've found, and you and I have been doing this a long time, is that the survey is just one piece of the entire puzzle. So I think your comment about how if you're looking to redo your program or you're just starting off on this journey, that customer listening architecture is really the way to go. What is Walker's approach to looking at the customer listening architecture, and how would you get started?
So now, if you've been paying attention, you probably already listened to the webcast that was done last week.
It was good.
Yes, it was. It was very good. But really,
except
at that
you
point,
weren't on it. That was the only problem.
No, Troy took my spot, yeah. But that's okay.
We're going to get him on the next episode.
Perfect. But no, actually, we tend to look at it in kind of three phases. So first is requirements, then it's planning, then it's execution. And when you think about it, the first stage of requirements requirements is really to know where you're going, you have to know where you're at today. So understanding, you know, do you have existing journey mapping at your disposal? What type of listening is already in place? And let's think about not only your annual relationship study or your event-triggered surveys, but where are you listening qualitatively? Where are you engaging one-on-one with executives or have other ways in which you're getting customer feedback in a structured or unstructured way? So understanding what's there, and then taking the time to make sure that you're engaging with the organization to really understand what the strategy is and how they see customer insights really supporting their success. And you can't forget to make sure that you're connecting externally. What's important to customers to make sure that you're kind of getting that external validation. One of the things we also often do within the requirements phase is leverage Walker's CX maturity assessment, which helps us to really understand where you are, not just in how you capture customer listening, but really across all of the elements that we see are essential to a successful CX program. And that includes your culture, your communication, and how you act on the data. So taking the time to really understand and assess your current state and define your ideal state. And the next phase is planning. And when we talk about planning, it really is about collaboratively designing what that listening architecture should look like. Walker's going to come with a lot of recommendations, but it has to be owned by the business. And so making sure that you have people engaged in your organization, giving lots of valuable input, because at the end of the day, for this to be successful, they have to own it, they have to believe in it, and they have to drive it throughout the organization. And during the planning phase, we also make sure that we are prioritizing. We don't think of things as what are you going to do tomorrow. We want to think long term. So we want to develop a 3-year roadmap. You may have tons of things that you want to do in your listening architecture and all different ways you want to hear from customers, but we're also realistic. You can't deploy all of those in the first year, and you shouldn't. You need to make sure that you're purposeful, that you're bringing the right insight in, you're understanding it, you're disseminating it, and you're acting on it. Don't just keep getting information. You have to have a plan to be able to do something with it on the back end as well. The final area is really execution. And for us, you know, that's usually where the handoff occurs. Our goal is to get you as equipped as possible with a plan of listening that really aligns not only to your organizational strategy, but really ties to key phases of the customer journey so that you're putting listening in place that's most important to your organization, but we know that's most important to your customers as well. Because you can put a lot of listening in place if it's not based on what they care about, your customers. Your actions are not going to have the effect and the outcome that you're looking for. So we do is we work to create that plan so that you are then equipped to take it from there. Make sure that you've got the right resources in place and that you're really ready to stand the CX listening system up within your organization.
So requirements, planning, and execution.
Yes.
It's kind of like building a house.
It absolutely is.
Designed for you, a custom house. So
yes.
We've used that analogy here on the webcast, and we're going to continue it through this series. But I think the other thing that you mentioned that I really just want to call out, too, is the CX maturity assessment and what a valuable tool that is. Everybody starts at some level. Everybody has strengths and everybody has weaknesses. But it really is unique to each business, because that's why you're a successful business, is that you've attracted customers that really like your products and solutions.
And actually, I've got a case study of a client that we've worked with, and I think one of the ways that they used the CX maturity assessment was great. So we've worked with Akamai Technologies about 4 years now. They are a great company.
Fascinating business. If you guys don't know about Akamai, look them up. It's a really cool business just to start with, and then they really are really, really good at customer listening and their customer experience.
They are. I've loved the opportunity to work with them. And, you know, when we first engaged with them a few years back, we did an assessment to really kind of understand their organizational strategy and how we can improve specifically some of the listening that they had in place. But in the past 4 years, their organization has significantly evolved, and more of the business is really looking to bring in customer insights. And so even though we've been working with them and sharing best practices and doing things on an ongoing basis, we realized it really was a good time to step back, get a handle on what their needs are so that we can kind of purposely plan out the next phase. And using the CX maturity assessment, we were able to not only understand their maturity, but compare it back to a few years ago and really recognize the progress they had made in the last few years, and then be able to key in on, well, what's the next phase for them? Everybody has, as you mentioned, their own story and their own stage in maturity. And it's not, it is about, you know, eventually being the best, but it's about recognizing where you are today and how to take those next key steps to continue your evolution.
Yeah, you can't become the best overnight. You've got to improve over time continuously to get to be the best.
Yeah. And one of the things I just want to share a little bit about how we've used a listening architecture with Akamai, because I think it's been a really great partnership, and I think they do a lot of things really right. And so what we recently did was, you know, we took a look at their current efforts that we support in terms of like relationship and transactional, and we had their customer journey map as a key foundation. So we took the time to work with them and really understand what is their customer journey, and we can use that as a foundation to really start to plan out where we put listening in place to get the most out of it. The next thing we started to do was really engage their executive leadership and then really throughout the organization, sales, support, marketing. They have a UX team that's really engaged in getting customer feedback. And everyone was really interested in bringing more customer insight into the business. And so being able to kind of cast the net wide, understand really how all different parts of the organization want to use customer listening helps us to come up with more impactful recommendations as we look at building out that architecture. And so we really took some time to map out the listening along the customer journey. And we took the time to make some recommendations. You know, we looked at some of their listening and told them we should stop that. You know, it's not a critical component. It's not the right time to be listening. But then offered up some areas where they should start listening. Even others where they had some listening in place, but it really could use some modification. And finally, presenting some long-term options and considerations, because again, we want to think long-term. And as you mentioned in the beginning, it's not just about one survey, and it's not just about quantitative surveys. You know, we think about including things like qualitative listening. And for Akamai, what's really important is how they engage through their customer advisory boards and their executive briefing centers. And with that as an organizational focus, we need to layer in that into their customer listening architecture, not just think about it as a survey.
That's great. It sounds like Akamai is fearless when it comes to customer experience and customer listening.
And they are. And one of the things that I love about them is they're really not afraid to switch things up. I mean, yeah. I've worked with organizations that are so tied to trends and history that they're afraid to make a change.
Yep.
And Akamai has this great balance of, sure, there are key metrics that they track and trend over time. They measure success. But they also introduce new and topical questions and listening posts to stay relevant and fresh and meaningful to the business. And I think that's how they keep the engagement and the interest over time.
Yeah, how many times have we seen in our careers the companies that just mash it up to one big number for the whole company and they track it month after month after quarter, year after year, and it just never moves. And that's what the architecture can do for you, is it can find that variance in there that allows you to analyze and find pockets where you're doing really, really well and things that you could improve on that would have an impact on the customer.
Absolutely. And be able to come in and out of it. You know, some of your listening is going to be a one-time topical deep dive to be able to answer a specific business question. Others are going to require some ongoing listening to be able to track and trend the impact that your actions and improvements are having on the customer experience. It's really about kind of balancing all of that and being very purposeful about how you plan that out. I think one of the things that we see in Akamai and a lot of other organizations is with a lot of companies trying to bring in a lot of different customer insights, we find that even when you have a centralized CX team, you have listening happening in various parts of the organization. And so it's wonderful that everybody's engaged and wants to get the voice of the customer. The challenge is being able to leverage that and collaborate and come up with that single source of truth and be able to really make sure that each listening complements the other to help tell the full story of the customer experience.
Right. And also to make sure you're not wearing out your customers with too many ad hoc surveys that don't get acted on, or that the customer perceives that nothing's going to happen if I take this survey.
Absolutely. And that's one of the reasons why we also see organizations going to kind of an enterprise-wide platform,
right,
is to be able to have full transparency and visibility. You're able to manage your sample a lot more effectively so that you're not overburdening customers. And it starts to almost help to facilitate that collaboration and that sharing by having all of that information available to be able to be used by the business.
You know, it occurs to me that just talking to you about this architecture is that one question we ought to ask before we launch a survey is, do we already have this information?
100%.
Yeah.
And the information can be from an existing customer survey that's already in place, or you might have operational data that's already stored within your systems that can help to get you 80% there.
Yeah, that's a great point. The process that you laid out earlier in the interview, requirements, planning, and execution, to me seems like it's almost a cycle. You know, you have requirements, you plan, then you execute, and then as you start to get feedback, it might redefine your requirements.
And it should be living, you know.
Yeah.
Your listening architecture is not something where you know, print out a map and you check it off and 3 years later you say, great, I'm done. You know, it should be something that you continually revisit, that you modify. Your organization's needs are going to change. Your customers' expectations are going to change. And your listening plan should change along with it.
In your experience, what's the inertia, or what are the constraints to an organization really adopting? You know, just this discussion with you makes it seem like it ought to be second nature, that any successful organization ought to be engaged in this. But what's been your take on why companies don't have a dynamic customer listening architecture process?
Well, I mentioned earlier, you know, some organizations get too tied to the number. And they're afraid to change because they're afraid that that change will change the number and they'll have to answer for that. So that's one of the first things that...
want to move the data.
No, we wouldn't. What? Keep it the same. We're doing great.
Yeah.
But really, I think it's also sometimes it's harder. You know, it's easier to just execute a survey than to take the time to really understand what your organizational strategy is, to really think about, you know, how you should put listening in place. I think some organizations think, you know, I don't have the resources to do all that listening. And I think that's where the prioritization comes into play. We recognize where you're at, and we help to identify where you should prioritize so that you can get the most out of the resources and your budget and the time that you have to dedicate to customer listening. So I think it's, and sometimes organizations think it's going to slow down the process. You know, you have to take a step back. But I think, you know, there's a lot of different ways that we're able to deploy customer listening architecture. Sometimes it's a variety of qualitative interviews over time. And other times, and I think Troy's going to talk about this, is, you know, we can do them in very quick workshop-like settings. So you can get to some really quick answers and plans in a collaborative fashion. So I think regardless of the time frame, you know, it's not as long as you think. We can get this done in just a few months and get and make sure that you're on the right track moving forward to get the most value out of your customer listening.
Excellent, Allison. Thanks for being on the podcast this time and for sharing your insights and your passion.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Allison Grayson is a vice president of consulting here at Walker. I think you can tell how skilled and how talented she is. And why don't you tell listeners how they might be able to get in touch with you if they want to have any follow-up on this topic?
Sure. You can get me at agrayson@walkerinfo.com, or you can call me directly, 317-843-8605.
Thanks, Allison. And if you want to talk about anything we've discussed or any of the other subjects we've covered here on the podcast or just customer experience in general, we'd love to hear from you. You can contact me at steve.walker@walkerinformation.com or call me here in the U.S., 317-843-8890. Don't hesitate to reach out to me or Allison or any of the other great people here at Walker. We'd love to talk to you more. If this is your first time listening, don't forget to subscribe to the podcast. Go to walkerinfo.com/podcast to see all of our episodes. And you can subscribe via iTunes, Google Play, Spotify, and iHeartRadio. And on our show notes page for this episode, you'll have a link where you can check out our recent webcast, Building Your Customer Listening Architecture. Our partners at Qualtrics joined us for this webcast and gave us a glimpse into the technological side of customer listening. Thank you for listening to the CX Leader Podcast, which is a production of Walker. We're a business consulting firm that can help make customer experience your biggest competitive advantage. Find out more at walkerinfo.com. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you on the next episode of the CX Leader Podcast.